I'm Brenda Jones Bray, and I have the distinct honor to serve as the chair of the Ways and Means Committee. Ways and Means is basically focuses on finance, especially budget, for Doylestown Township. And the committee is comprised of myself, Joseph Dollicott, who was just recently appointed or elected as vice chairman, Eric Cornwell, Colleen Mullen, Mike Pawlowski, and Bob Selnick, and Joe Volk. Several of the members, Joe Dollicott and Bob Selnick and Colleen, have been on the committee for a number of years, right along with Mike as well. And our two new members this year for 2020 are Eric and Joseph Volk. So, you may be wondering, what does Ways and Means do, and what is their impact on the community during, particularly the last year? Obviously, the township administration prepares all the information, but at our meetings, we talk about relevant points that are going on in the community and affecting the finances of Doylestown Township. One of the things that we focused on, of course, was COVID during 2020. And we were involved in reviewing the EIT and other revenues that were impacted by the virus and the pandemic. And we also took a look at expenditures, but to a lesser degree. Another big project this year was a banknote borrowing. A few years ago, when the township building, in which we're seated tonight, was built, we needed to reimburse the general fund, or the township did, for monies that were spent on the building. So with the administration and the finance department, the Ways and Means was involved in determining how much to borrow based on cash flow projections put together by township administration and investments, comparing banknotes, or comparing a borrowing of a banknote to a bond issue, and then a recommendation to work with a public financial management financial advisory firm out of Harrisburg. A third point that we did, we continued, and this is about the third or fourth year that Ways and Means has been supporting and working alongside the Pension Advisory Committee's budget recommendation related to retirement or the pension for both uniform and non-uniform employees. Another project, multiple year, has been the proposed community recreation center, where to build it, how to move forward, size, and scheduling, potential scheduling of that facility. We completed a CapEx form for additional bathrooms for Central Park Complex. That was something different for Ways and Means this year, but we talked about it throughout the year, starting in January of 2020. Lastly, but most importantly, and actually I think one of the main reasons that the Ways and Means Committee came into being, I think 15, 16 years ago, was to help review of the 2021 budget capital projects and five-year plan. Again, I want to just reiterate that the township administration and personnel do all the work. We just sit and have conversations and make recommendations and help out in any way that the Ways and Means can. Sometimes that means just helping with transparency, a word that oftentimes not everyone is fond of, but also to make it more understandable. Although there are two CPAs on the Ways and Means Committee, and we tend to get stuck in our own jargon from time to time. During the year, I've kind of mentioned it already, Ways and Means worked closely with the Pension Advisory Committee and on the pension, and then the Park and Recreation Board related to, once again, the Community Recreation Center. What are we going to do in 2021? Always a good question, and sometimes we are a little ambitious in our goals when we move forward. During the year, we started learning and more about Doylestown Township Municipal Authority, DTMA. So we'd like to have a better understanding of the finances of that particular component unit of the township. There's analysis and benchmarking of salaries and fringe benefits. I believe the board, the Board of Supervisors just approved a contract to have that done by an outside group. But we hope to be involved in the analysis and reading afterwards for future planning for the township. Continued involvement with the Community Recreation Center on the business plan and also debt, and most immediately coming up, meeting with the architects that are closely working on the design for the proposed recreation center. There's a possibility to advance refund of the existing debt, very technical term for most people, but it's just like looking at refinancing your own mortgage. So that's on the list for 2021. We also have had conversations recently at the committee about trying to address or list some service enhancements for the community. That sounds rather nebulous, but what can we do, what can even the township do to better serve residents and as far as services or amenities? Also, always keeping cost in mind. And lastly, but again, most importantly, because it has to do with taxes and the income for the township, the review of the 2020 budget capital projects and the five-year plan, which does include the millage or a tax plan. This particular task has really developed through the years of the Ways and Means working with the township. There are three long meetings for the Board of Supervisors where many facets of finances and assumptions are covered as we move forward, not just 1 year, but 5 years into the future. 2020 was certainly an interesting year for the Ways and Means Committee, as it was for all. Meeting on Zoom and not being able to get together in subcommittees and attending board meetings made it a challenging year. We're all looking forward, the committee, to moving ahead in 2021 with getting back to in-person meetings, although not immediately, we understand that. And to the public, I would like to invite all of you to join us, whether it be on Zoom or come out to our monthly meetings. We meet on the fourth Wednesday of the month, all months except for November, and we're a little earlier in December due to the holidays and winter break. If you have questions, we're available. Our information is available again through the administration here at the Township Building. Thank you.